Now we're going to add the CMSS and repeaters to radio management. I'll be configuring them in another video, but for now, let's just get them added and read. To do this, we'll need to start radio management. As you can see, I have a blank database, but the system I'm using is already configured, so when I come to the settings, some things will already be there. Capacity Max uses radio management, which means that the system, in other words, radios plus infrastructure, is set up as a whole, rather than having hundreds of code plugs for everything. The first thing I'm going to add is the CMSS. To do this, I'll need to enter its serial number. Now, there are two serial numbers on the CMSS, the 10-character Motorola one that's on the packing list, and the HPE one. You'll need to enter the HPE one, which can be found on the pull-out card on the front of the CMSS. You don't have to, but I prefer to enter the CAI number together with the serial number at this point, which in almost all cases will be 12. Now let's crack on and add the repeaters. I have two in the system. Now, if your eyesight is anything like mine, you'll probably have a hard time reading the serial numbers of the chassis. Of course, you can get it off the packing list, but here's a more elegant way of getting the serial number. First, you need to plug in the programming cable, and then start Radio Management Device Programmer. The repeater uses DNS service discovery and will announce itself to the device programmer PC. Here, you can simply copy and paste the serial number into radio management. I'm using the programming cable now, but once the system is set up, I'll be able to program the repeaters via IP. Once I've added the serial number, I'm going to schedule a read. This is needed to get the repeater configuration into radio management, so you'll notice that I've ticked Generate Configuration and Apply to Radio. Now let's repeat that exercise for the second repeater. Now that I've added and read the repeaters, I would now like to read the CMSS. To do this, I'll need to add a few settings. The first is to create a new IP system for the CMSS. This basically tells radio management that this is a CMSS and the trunk controller is at this IP address. Then I need to apply those settings to the CMSS. The next thing I need to do is to create a MVO. This tells radio management that this is a CMSS that uses IP to communicate. MVO stands for Mobile Version Options and is a piece of data that tells radio management what type of device this is. Once I've done that, I can read the CMSS. It does take a few seconds and appears to be doing nothing, but it will read. Now that I've added infrastructure devices to the radio management, I can start setting this equipment up.